Thought Park Fright Nights and Alton Towers Scarefest. These are two events that return every year in October to celebrate Halloween. Recently, some new announcements were made and preparation has begun on both events, which is leading us to speculate and to see what could be returning to both of these events. So that is what we're going to be doing today. Hope you enjoyed this video. Please don't forget to like and subscribe to never miss another theme park update. Hey, welcome back or welcome to my channel. My name is Aiden and I will be your guide into the world of theme parks for today. Today I'd like to get a little bit spooky by talking about Alton Towers Scarefest and Thought Park Fright Night. And you're probably wondering why I'm doing this so early in the year. Halloween is in October, for goodness sake. You might think I'm going mad, but here's the thing, you are wrong, because there's already so much preparation for both events going on in both parks. So let's talk first a little bit about Fright Night. Now, this event has been at the park since 2002 and has seen so many great attractions such as the Asylum, the Big Top and more recently Stitches, which was their headliner for 2023. This event has been going strong for such a long time and has grown in popularity in more recent years, and a couple of days ago we got a bit more information as to what we could expect at this year's event. It says, with epic new heights comes petrifying new lows, from sinister scare mazes to spine-tingling evil scare zones. Evil lurks around every corner. Thus, experience an all-time in our brand new maze for 2024. Watch this space. Now, people have thought that there will be four mazes at this year's event, so instead of replacing an old maze, they can expand their event and keep on adding each year. And I can totally back this up. I think there's a lot of solid evidence to prove that this is true. I discovered this Wednesday there was a new webpage on the Thought Park website, and when I was looking online, it mentions unlimited access to all four mazes. Now, when I clicked on the link, it said they couldn't find this page. Suspicious. Now, this tells us a lot. First of all, it states there are four mazes, and secondly, it says unlimited access. So, could we be seeing the frequent frights pass again? It was a new thing introduced last year for £99, I think it was. You're allowed unlimited access in the mazes every time you visit the event. Or could we be seeing like a new type of ticket where you're permitted access to the mazes for the whole day? I have my money on the frequent frights pass. So, that's pretty much all I have to say about Fright Nights this year, but now let's get into the good stuff, Alton Towers Scarefest. Now, before we get into detail about this event, I'm just going to put my cards on the table and say what we know so far about 2024. So, Alton have confirmed that they're trying to improve the events on offer, which is why they've not put Festival of Thrills or Mardi Gras on this year, so they can focus more on the headline events such as Oktoberfest and Scarefest. From what I've also heard, they want to make one of their biggest Scarefest events to date. That's a pretty big thing. So Hex is also reopening in autumn of this year in time for spooky season. The Alton Towers dungeons closed just over a week ago to make way for a new Scarefest attraction. The Wicker Man Scare Zone Burial Grounds has already been put up and it's now running alongside the Wicker Man queue. And let's not forget the obvious, two Survivor Games shaped buildings are being constructed on park, one by Alton Manor and the other where Darkest Depths used to be. I'm going to let you into a secret, it's probably not going to return. So that's what we know regarding the Fest of the Scare, but there are so many questions that we still need to answer, such as how many mazes will there be? We already know that there are four mazes at Thought Park, and with the fact that Alton Towers do want to make their event bigger and better, it just seems really reasonable. Altonville Mine Tours is still there, the theming is right next to the tunnel by X Sector, also with the fact that Tiny's Revenge saw the reimagining of the attraction. The park won't scrap a newish attraction after 1 year, and they also wouldn't scrap the iconic Terror of the Towers brand. I can see both mazes staying for this year, even if Terror of the Towers doesn't stay as the attic this year and becomes a new maze within the towers. So that is four mazes there, Tiny's Revenge, the attic, plus those two new mazes. So also if Das Games Panic does return, that is five paid scare attractions, not forgetting the Dungeons and Trick or Treat Town, which leads up to seven unpaid attractions. And that is a lot for one theme park event. So, with that in mind, could we be seeing the frequent frights pass for Alton Towers? We could call it subsequent spooks. But I think this is a great option, as it could be good value for money, with an infinite amount of run-throughs for a maximum of 7 up-paid attractions. This may be quite an expensive event this year, but, you know, with a frequent fright, would you buy it for around £100? I think I would. So I'm going to leave it there for today. So what do you think could be coming this year? Do you think I'm on the right track or am I completely wrong? Thank you so much for watching. My name is Aidan, also known as Official Theme Park Lover. If you enjoyed this video, hit like, subscribe and all that nonsense, and I will see you very, very soon. Goodbye.